I'm Scott Drayton. I'm a senior project manager here at Power Engineers.
I'm Jonathan Bader. I'm a mechanical engineer by background, and I lead our RNG focus group here at Power Engineers. Today, we are going to go over some of the basics of renewable natural gas.
It's important because we have a source of energy available that we're wasting that we can put to good use.
Natural gas is primarily methane. It's roughly 95% methane, and it typically has a heating value of around 1,000 BTU per cubic foot.
So fossil natural gas, we drill into the ground, extract the gas, capture it, filter out the stuff that we don't want, and send it on into your house for cooking or heating, or it can even be used for automobile fuel. But you don't have to use fossil natural gas. We can use renewable natural gas instead. Renewable natural gas has the exact same composition and quality as fossil natural gas. For renewable natural gas, or RNG, as organic material decomposes, we capture that off gas rather than let it escape and pollute the atmosphere. We filter it as well and can send that right into your house to be burned exactly like fossil natural gas. There are several different sources for RNG. About 65% of the available feedstock comes from landfills. About 25% available comes from agricultural waste. About 5% comes from food waste. And about 5% comes from wastewater treatment plants. RNG is sustainable because we're using byproducts of living our lives to do something useful that we're already doing anyway, as opposed to letting that methane pollute into our air.
RNG can actually have up to 88% less carbon emissions than fossil natural gas. With RNG having, you know, an identical composition to natural gas, it can use the exact same natural gas pipeline infrastructure that's already in place in the United States. RNG in the U.S. at least has a potential to be able to displace up to 15% of the current natural gas usage in the United States.
The number of RNG projects has doubled in the last 5 years. Currently in the United States, there's 385 million cubic feet per day of production. The states of Pennsylvania, Texas, and California are leading the way by volume.
RNG has support from the RFS and from the IRA tax credits. You also have corporations and utilities that have their own mandates for renewable energy. There's significant investment currently, and in 2023 alone, we saw up to $1.8 billion invested on RNG projects.
The remainder of the world is engaging in investigating and looking for opportunity, and there's opportunity to be had. The European countries have been heavily engaged in RNG production for some time. As an example, Germany alone makes 20% of the global RNG production itself.
Processing technology is fairly mature, but there is continuing investment and developments. More recently, we're actually seeing new feedstocks getting away from your traditional animal waste, landfill, wastewater plants. You're also seeing biomass gasification plants that are looking at producing renewable natural gas. Landfill gas in particular, we're seeing a lot of focus and attention on tuning of the well fields right now. So by tuning the well fields to make sure you're not pulling in too much atmosphere, that makes the gas processing side of things on the RNG facility more streamlined and energy efficient.
One of the key items for Power Engineers is to get in and get to know our client, get to know the project first, then we can formulate a team around that to execute well.
You know, we get involved in projects on the back end, but very often we're involved in preliminary design, helping specify equipment, supporting air permitting. That's all something that's right in our wheelhouse. Project Assai is actually one of the largest landfill gas to RNG facilities in the United States. That was a project that we got involved in very early in the project's development, supported the team with preliminary engineering to support permitting processes, and we moved into detailed design for the foundations for this facility and all of the underground piping. The Westmoreland project was a project for Noble Environmental. That facility actually processes 2,000 SCFM of landfill gas. And that project actually led into some future work with Noble that we're currently working on. We're excited to be a part of these type of projects and the energy transition. The outlook and the future for RNG is great.
Our team at Power Engineers has done this several times. We have a lot of successful projects under our belt. We have engineers on staff to do all of the design work and be particularly careful about the things that make RNG successful.